Still, don't move. We have to stay still. Stare right into the camera. Easier said than done. We haven't blinked for 10 minutes. Is he done? Oh, he's pulling out his head again. What's wrong now? Somebody's moved? It's probably Maria, the one with the bob cut behind me. She was the last to arrive, like she didn't want to. She didn't want to come to the shop because if you are a cleaner, you end up with your hands getting stained. And no one is going to dance with a lady whose hands are stained black. She wanted to be a tailor, but we don't need tailors in Valenza. We need cleaners. Or maybe it was that scoundrel, my son, right in front of me, with those long and straight hair covering all the cleaners behind him. He should have stayed home. I never see him here that often anyway. Oh yes, he doesn't want to be a goldsmith. He'd rather study, travel the world, why not? After all, it's Daddy that is paying the bills. Yet, the photograph was his idea. He asked his friend Niccolo Scarpa, who has been running a photo laboratory for a year now in Verona. That's why his photographer best friend put the scoundrel at the center of the picture. In any case, he's done the right thing to put him there because the boy is beautiful. I'm not saying this because I'm his father. He's taking his looks from his mother. He doesn't look at all like me, not even his voice. I do have a beautiful voice, though. They say I sound like a baritone. Shame you can get that in the picture. I wonder whether you can see those beautiful plaster casts at the end of the room. They're also the casts of the jewels we made in the workshop I owned before. Before the war. That ugly war. However, I opened my shop again. You can't stop Vincenzo Cerriana. I opened it up 2 years ago in 1920, and we're larger than before. Carlo, the one with the flat cap, he's been with me forever. He's my best goldsmith. He's good, but he's always cold. I never seen him without his cap and scarf, not even in August. He says this way he doesn't get bitten by mosquitoes. He knows we're here for the picture. Can't he wear a hat and a scarf with the same pattern? Not a checked and a striped one. Yet, you can talk to him. He gets angry for nothing. And when he does, he runs down the Po River with his fishing rod to relax and calm down. And you have to chase him every time and apologize. I'm sorry, Carlo. Please come back. I can't do anything without you. What time is it? 11:30. Good God! We wasted all morning. Draw benches sitting idle, hammers being silent, the balance scale lying still under the sun. It took Hercules' strength to get it here. No one is blowing the welding torches. How much is this picture going to cost between what I spend and the money I'm not earning? 100 years from now, what will those people looking at this photograph think? Look at those two on the right. The ones placing the stones, holding their tools in their hands as if they were little lit torches. All right, good God, we're finished. Had we stayed a second longer, my glasses would have slipped from my nose. I was afraid we had to stay here for another hour without eating. Today, Rina has prepared a nice meat sauce. I can smell its scent coming from the floor above. I wonder how jewels will be made in Valenza 100 years from now. What kind of machine will people invent? But I say that what will always count more than machines will be the hands using them. You will still have to use hands to make jewels, and our hands are as precious as gold.